It's the FCS semifinal. South Dakota State on the road at James Madison tomorrow afternoon, and this is Game Day Eve from GoJacks.com. I'm Tyler Merriam, joined by Mike Struck, and Strucky was adamant we had to go to his home away from home this week, so here we are inside the weight room.
Yeah, it's very impressive weight room here, a place I spent a lot of time in during my college years, and or maybe not.
You so. Almost said that with a straight face.
Yeah.
56-14, the Jacks were victorious in the quarterfinals over New Hampshire. That's a Wildcat team that hadn't given up more than 21 points in 2 months. SDSU hung 21 on them in the first quarter.
Well, the Jacks really came out on fire, and they were clicking on all cylinders. And, you know, when the Jacks are able to get the ball, the opening kickoff, and they drive down the field and put a touchdown on the board, that just enlightens everyone on that squad. And they just carry that momentum, and the defense goes out and gets the ball back to the offense in good field position. And then next thing you know, Jacks put up another touchdown, and they're up 14-0 early in the game. And so, you know, they just carried the momentum and the emotion of that game against New Hampshire. And before you knew it, New Hampshire is down 21-0 and not even out of the first quarter yet, and just not quite sure what had hit them.
Terrific performance by the Jacks. Another CAA team is the opposition tomorrow, but this is a much different animal, the Dukes of James Madison. They have won 25 in a row, the defending national champions, undefeated this year, the number one seed in the FCS playoffs. I mean, this is an elite program in the FCS. The Jacks feel they are elite as well. They'll have a chance to prove it tomorrow.
Well, in all the rankings that James Madison has, they're certainly deserving of those rankings. They proved it. They went into Fargo last year in the playoffs and took down North Dakota State on the road, which is a very impressive thing to do in the playoffs. Carried that into that national championship game, won it, and then went out this year and just continued to play very excellent football. And they're a very, very solid team all across the board. They're just like everyone else at this time of year. They've had their fair share of injuries, but they've been able to develop depth along the way and really aren't missing too much of a beat by having to fill in some of those spots, and so they just continue to play at a very high level.
JMU good on both sides of the ball. We start with offense, and Brian Shore, one of the most accurate passers in all of the FCS, 24 touchdowns to 12 interceptions. He, like Taryn Christian, a quiet leader who has a ton of respect not only for how he leads his team but how he performs on the field as well.
Yeah, I really like Brian Shore and how he plays the game of football. You know, he does what is asked of him in the offense. He's a tough kid, in my opinion. He's not afraid to tuck the ball under and run. He takes his fair share of hits, but he throws a very nice ball. And he really leads that offense in that he kind of brings that composure to him, and he gets him settled down, just makes plays. And that's the kind of guy you want leading a football team. He's just a winner. He's a good leader. And just overall, very, very solid quarterback.
And he has a lot of weapons, multiple backs he can rely on to hand the football to, five receivers between 28 and 49 receptions on the year. So this is a versatile offensive unit Shore has to play with.
And that's probably what's most dangerous about them is they maybe don't have that one guy that they rely on. And so they spread the ball around. They are very athletic playmakers, and they have a tremendous number of yards after catches or after contact, and so they're a very, very dangerous offense.
Number one scoring defense in the country when you turn to the other side of the ball. They gave up 28 to Weber State in the quarterfinal win, most points they've allowed all season, for the year averaging 10.3 points per game allowed.
That's just solid. That defense is just so athletic, and they just have so much team speed that it's really hard to get the edge on them, and they just guys are able to run sideline to sideline. I watched that Weber State game. I was a little surprised that Weber State was able to put up the points, but Weber State's a very good football team too. But I think the one thing that Weber State did is they were very patient in that they didn't give up on the run. And so they maybe were only getting a yard or 2 yards a crack, but they continued to stay with the run. And, you know, in my opinion, probably wore down that James Madison defense a little bit in the fourth quarter. They're not used to having teams be able to drive the field on them, and I think that's part of what led to Weber State having as much success as they did, is they just continued to stay patient with that running game.
Let's talk about JMU's defense a little more specifically. They get to the quarterback as well as anybody in the nation, 43 sacks, anchored by the defensive end of the Colonials Defensive Player of the Year, Andrew Ankrum.
Impressive. That's the best way to describe him. He is very, very impressive. He's got all the physical attributes. He's got the speed, the determination. What I thought watching film was they do a very good job of not staying blocked. There's the initial point of contact, but they fight off blocks and get the ball carriers.
25 interceptions, the most INTs by a defensive unit in all of the FCS, and all four of their starting members, the secondary, earned some type of all-CAA honor.
Impressive speed. They just have overall great speed in the secondary. There's not a lot of really wide open angles to hit receivers with. It's tight windows. You have to really be on the mark with the ball with your throws, or they're going to get a hand on it. They're able, great closing speed. You know, if a guy initially makes a move and creates some separation, they're able to close the distance in a hurry. Just ball hawking. They play the game like you want defensive backs to play the game. As they get after it, they're physical, and they get to the ball.
Jackrabbit head coach John Stiglmeyer thinks the special teams are a very even matchup. When you look at JMU, they're very good in the return game, one of the best net punting units in the country, and obviously Ethan Rackey, that game-winning field goal with no time left to beat Weber State last Friday.
That was an impressive kick by Rackey. You know, a lot of pressure on. You know, the nice thing about it was it wasn't like they were behind. If he misses it, they go to overtime. But still, that's a tremendous amount of pressure for a young guy. And he went out and just nailed it. And they do a really good job overall with all of their special teams. They spend a lot of time coaching it up and practicing it. And that's what you have to do to be a top-tier program, and James Madison is doing that.
And the other thing, too, SDSU will contend with is some noise on the road. Bridgeforth Stadium is a phenomenal facility, one of the best in the FCS. They averaged over 24,000 during the regular season. The two playoff games have been at right around 15,000 for an average. It will be loud and hostile there on Saturday afternoon.
It will be, but I think the Missouri Valley Football Conference kind of sets up SDSU for this type of game because they played in very hostile environments. And so you've got a lot of veteran guys on the SDSU team, and so I think they'll be able to handle it. The offense pretty much goes with a silent count throughout the course of the season anyways, so I don't expect them to have too many problems with that. But there will have to be some communication when it gets really loud just to make sure that those offensive tackles are able to get the snap count and, you know, get off the ball with that pressure that's coming off the edges.
I'm just glad folks don't see the hand signals you give me on the silent count in the booth. South Dakota State, the 5 seed, James Madison, the 1 in the FCS semifinals, 3:30 Central Time tomorrow afternoon. You can watch the game on ESPNU. Our radio coverage throughout the Jackrabbit Sports Network begins at 2:30 Central Time in the heart of the Shenandoah Valley in Harrisonburg, Virginia.